Aged and modern electronics is built on voltage, current and resistance. The relation between those fundamental electrical variables are described in Ohm's law. Resistance equals voltage divided by current, or voltage equals resistance multiplied by current, or current equals voltage divided by resistance. You get what I mean. A multimeter is capable of measuring all those important parameters. It's easy to use and the price for a simple one is affordable. That's why I'm going to show you how to use a basic multimeter to measure voltage, current and resistance. You get probes with every multimeter. These are essential for measuring. The easiest measurement would be the resistance. Just select the ohm sign. Yeah guys, that is an ohm sign. And stick your probes in the right socket. The black probe always connects to the common socket, so you don't have to worry about that. The red probe must only be changed if you measure current. Voltage and resistance is always the same socket. Now you can measure the resistance by just connecting one probe to one side of the resistor and the other probe to the other side of the resistor. I said it would be easy. The resistor is around 68 kilo ohms, but measuring the resistance in a built circuit will mostly fail, because current chooses the way of least resistance, meaning that the measuring current will not only flow through that one resistor. Here I have the same resistor in the original circuit and it tells me 58 kilo ohms, which is bullshit. Right next to the ohm sign is another awesome feature, the continuity. The meter will beep whenever there is almost zero resistance between the two probes. That means when the probes touch each other, it will beep. Great way to check for cable breaks. And if the cable is broken, no beeps for you. Moving on to voltage, we have to distinguish between alternating current and direct current. Most people, including me, will mostly use DC. Batteries, your bench power supply output, in my case a modified ATX power supply, or your laptop charger output, all DC. But don't you dare to touch the insides of those power supplies. That's the place where AC becomes DC. That's dangerous and it can kill you. We measure voltage in parallel, so connect the red probe to the positive side and the black probe to the negative side of your power source. Good way to find out whether your batteries are still useful. Another example. I want to hook up this LED with those cables. I thought I did everything right and I get 3.3 volts at the power supply, but there's no voltage at the LED leads. There must be something wrong with the cables. Oh, I see it. Measuring current is the hardest part, but still easy. Let's only take a look at DC. Switch the red probe to the 10 amp socket. Why 10 amps? Always start with the high current sockets, cause the other socket can only endure up to 500 milliamps. The fuse is gonna blow up when you try to measure higher current. We have to open the electric circuit to measure the current. Connect the probes to the opening points of the circuit, so the current of the circuit will also flow through the multimeter. And it works! Let's switch to the smaller range to get more precision. And what the hell? It doesn't work. I think the fuse is down. Time for replacement. Unscrew your multimeter and locate the smaller fuse. Buy yourself the right one with the same values and replace it. Screw everything back together and you are done. And those were the basic features. If you're looking for a simple one which does just what I described, you're lucky. I put a link in the description below. If you learned something today, don't forget to like and share this video. Also check out my latest video and subscribe for more electronic knowledge. See you next time!